Hi, my name is Prasid Arora, and I'm a product manager on the Azure Edge and Platform team here at Microsoft. In this session, we'll cover how you can use the Azure Portal to get under the hood of your Azure Stack HCI cluster and fix issues using Windows Admin Center. Windows Admin Center has been around as an on-premises management tool for the last 5 years. It provides centralized and simplified management for your Windows Server, Windows Client, and Azure Stack HCI clusters through a user-friendly interface. It features deep monitoring, such as Performance Monitor, Event Viewer, Packet Monitoring, to help troubleshoot and investigate problems. And then granular configuration with tools such as Certificate Manager, Firewall Manager, Volume Manager, and dozens others to help fix these problems. In this session, let's explore how you can perform an end-to-end drill-down management of your Azure Arc-enabled infrastructure, all within the Azure portal, with Windows Admin Center in Azure. Let's look at an example of a hypothetical company, Contoso, a retail company with stores all around the world. Most of their infrastructure runs in the Azure public cloud, but there are a few applications that need to run on-premises. Being a retail store, they need their point-of-sale application and their video monitoring applications all running on-premises. Because these applications are critical to their daily sales, it's absolutely crucial that these applications have resiliency and redundancy. Therefore, Contoso has deployed either 2, 3, or 4 node Azure Stack HCI clusters in all of their stores. One in New York, one in Bogota, Stockholm, Beijing, Brisbane, and many more. They have a centralized IT team that manages all of these clusters remotely, based here in Seattle, Washington. Because all of Contoso's infrastructure runs in Azure, their IT administrators are very well versed in using the Azure portal for all of their management, and are excited to continue to use the Azure portal for managing their clusters. So how can their IT team monitor and manage their on-prem infrastructure centrally? So Contoso uses Azure Monitor to manage all of their existing cloud infrastructure and continue to use Azure Monitor to manage their on-premises infrastructure too. Because all of these clusters are Azure Arc enabled, they're able to leverage the power of Azure Arc to monitor all of their infrastructure centrally via Azure Monitor. They're able to centrally monitor all of their infrastructure, build custom visualizations and dashboards, and scale to monitoring hundreds of servers and clusters as their retail business grows. While their IT team was monitoring their clusters, they recently got a health alert that one of their clusters was in a critical state, and they needed to remedy the situation as soon as possible. So they opened up the Azure portal to their monitoring dashboard and see that one of their clusters is indeed in a critical state, and the faulting resource is the volume. So within Azure Monitor, they're able to navigate to the storage tab and see one of their volumes of their cluster is actually down. How do they fix this? Now, traditionally, you would have to perform a few steps to remedy a situation like this on your on-premises infrastructure. You would need to first establish line of sight to your infrastructure. This could mean setting up a VPN, which is generally an expensive, time-consuming, and painful process. Or if you have absolutely no inbound network connectivity to your on-prem infrastructure, usually to prevent an attack surface, you would have to fly someone out to your retail store or send someone out to this retail store in order to actually investigate or troubleshoot the issue. Or ask someone to actually open some inbound connectivity to your infrastructure, opening you up to some amount of unknown attack surface. Once you do establish this line of sight, you would need to have the administrator credentials of this cluster and ensure that those administrator credentials are well secured. Whether you're passing that off from person to person or securing it through Azure Key Vault, you do need to have local administrator credentials to manage the server. And then lastly, you need to use some set of external tooling like Remote Desktop or Server Manager, Hyper-V Manager, or even Windows Admin Center deployed locally in order to look at the environment and troubleshoot it to bring the volume back up. For a company like Contoso, who spent the entire lifespan in the Azure portal for their end-to-end management, This is a rather painful process, which requires the learning of many new technologies. For one, they have to use a different management tooling, leaving the comfort of the Azure portal, whether it's RDP, Server Manager, Hyper-V Manager, to actually manage this particular server. You have to establish line of sight through VPN or sending someone on site, both being pretty expensive processes. And lastly, they can't use Azure AD authentication or Azure 2FA, Azure two-factor authentication, to manage the cluster anymore. They have to worry about local administrator credentials to run any sort of local commands. Fortunately, Contoso has Azure Stack HCI, and they don't have to worry about any of these problems. They can manage their Azure Arc-enabled infrastructure directly from the Azure portal with the Windows Admin Center extension. They get all of the tools that they're familiar with for monitoring and management with the Windows Admin Center, all available natively in the Azure portal. Access to this management tooling is controlled via Azure role-based access control, so there's no need to worry about any local administrator credentials. It's all available from anywhere as long as they have access to the Azure portal. Their centralized IT team sitting in Seattle is able to access any sort of set of tooling they need to access their cluster. Let's look at how this works and how Contoso can bring back this volume of their cluster sitting in New York while staying in Seattle. Let's navigate to this cluster in the Azure portal. On the left, there's a blade for Windows Admin Center. Since this is the first time that Contoso is using Windows Admin Center to manage this cluster from Azure, there's a short one-time setup process. Let's click Setup and Install and have Azure deploy Windows Admin Center on this cluster. The process for setting up Windows Admin Center is very similar to the process of deploying Azure Monitor, for example, on this cluster. It deploys a small agent onto this cluster that communicates with the Azure control plane to collect logs and perform operations. In the future, Contoso could use Azure CLI or PowerShell or Azure Policy to deploy Windows Admin Center at scale across all of their Azure Arc-enabled infrastructure, so it's always accessible when they need it. Once installation is complete, I can connect to my cluster. Connection to Windows Admin Center is controlled through an Azure RBAC group called Windows Admin Center Administrator Login, and I am already part of this group. But let's check it out in the Access Control tab. I must be a part of this group in order to access Windows Admin Center, and thus access my cluster using Azure AD credentials. Now let's actually go back to Windows Admin Center and hit Connect. And Windows Admin Center begins to load. And here's the beauty to all of this. I have no access to the cluster, no VPN, no public IP address. Actually, all inbound connectivity to this cluster has been blocked. But with Windows Admin Center, I'm able to start managing the operating system of this cluster. Here on the dashboard, I see the same alert that Azure Monitor reported to me. One of my volumes is inaccessible. Let's go find out why. It seems it went offline some time ago, and I can navigate to the built-in event viewer in Windows Admin Center to troubleshoot why. But for now, Contoso needs this cluster up immediately. So let's navigate to the volume tool and click the online button to remedy the situation. The volume will come back online, and in a few minutes, Azure Monitor will once again report that this cluster is in a healthy state. On the left here, Contoso actually has a huge set of tools to manage this particular cluster. In this case, they only needed to open up the volumes tool, but they can change granular settings, manage their security, manage granular settings of their virtual machines, their individual servers, drives, and much, much more. I can go to each individual node in this cluster and get an even deeper set of tools for managing this cluster, from certificates to devices to events to PowerShell and even a native RDP session if needed, all available in the Azure portal. And this might seem like magic right now, but so let's look at the architecture of Windows Admin Center in Azure to get a better idea of how this works. First, the Azure portal securely retrieves the entire front end of Windows Admin Center, such as the styles, the PowerShell scripts, the font, all from Azure CDN, globally cached for performance. Next, the Windows Admin Center backend, which is a small agent that is deployed on each node of the cluster for resiliency, and issued a Microsoft signed TLS certificate is deployed on every node of the cluster. Since each of these agents gets HTTPS calls, they must have a publicly signed TLS certificate for your browser to be able to securely communicate with. Then the Azure portal picks a node from your HCI cluster and sends remote PowerShell calls to that node. It's these remote PowerShell calls that perform actions such as bringing a volume back up or viewing your disks, certificates, and so on. The Azure Arc connectivity solution provides inbound HTTPS access to Windows Admin Center without requiring any inbound ports at all. It communicates entirely outbound. Lastly, the Windows Admin Center backend running on your HCI cluster responds and can manage all of the nodes of the cluster since they're all part of the same network. And all of these four steps working together light up the magic and allow you to access Windows Admin Center and thus your cluster all from the Azure portal. I hope you enjoyed this session. Here are some resources to start using Windows Admin Center and Azure to manage your Azure Arc-enabled servers and Azure Stack HCI clusters right from Azure. Thank you.